Hello everyone, this is Jonah the Orange, and today I'm playing the Cynane Pikes, which I've got to say has turned out to be my favourite unit. Millie's on the backbench a little bit. Maybe he'll make a comeback once I tear him up a bit. He needs a few more tears, he hasn't cried enough yet. But in the meantime, it's all about Aminius and Cynane for me, really. That's the two commanders I'm really loving at the moment. I have been playing a bit of Germanicus. It is fun, but the units I have on him don't have pylums, and that brings your funness level down to about a fucking zero. Which is why I am playing a bit of Cynane right now. She really knows how to have a good fucking time. Even though the tier 7 pikes do not have pike gnosis, which is the greatest ability you can possibly have on a unit, she still has her rapid advance, and you may notice I never raise my shields. The reason being is I don't give a fuck. No, the real reason is it just slows you down, and I want to be quick. I want to be quick on my feet. I want to be moving at all times. That way, I can get into combat as early as possible. If I keep popping that raised shields ability, the enemy is still going to do damage to me shooting at me. And I'm going to be losing troops. The enemy can redeploy, basically. It's just a shit show. If I wanted to play that type of game, I'd rather be Leonidas. But I'm not playing that fucking game. I'm playing the game of hunting elephants because I'm the fucking elephant hunter, okay? So once those elephants have engaged me, I use that rapid advance to walk backwards and turn. I just turn until the big numbers come in like that. Keep doing it, you get them down very quickly. And I've got to say, for something that seems so damn overpowered, you never see people use it. It's rarely in the game. How often do you actually see Cynane Pikes? I think the main reason for that is because if you make one slight mistake, you let them charge you one too many times and you're fucked. There is no shield bash to get out of trouble. Also, while they are quick for Pikes, they can still be kited pretty easily. That is the biggest downfall of this unit. That's why I do have my ally bring archers. That's Danite right there. He also does a bit of Twitch. You can check him out on his Twitch channel that I'll leave below. On a side note, I have found out what barricades are good at now. And that is fucking up pikes because they split them in half. It's still not too bad that the unit will get around them eventually. But it does mess them up a lot more than stakes. When it comes to stakes, you can just walk through the fucking things. And I'd say it's actually a good idea to walk through them. There's usually a unit AFK behind those stakes. They don't think you'll do it. They don't think you'll fucking do it, but you'll do it, alright? As you can see there, even though my pikes were on low health, they still have a wide formation. So that's the other advantage of actually playing this unit. It doesn't matter how many troops you have left. You can still rack up them points. The biggest disadvantage is that war dogs are reasonably popular now. You will run into a few of them, and they just fucking clean Cynane up. She does not have anything to beat them with. I mean, literally nothing. There's just nothing there. But that's fair enough. That's where you just have to rely on your allies to help you out. And no unit should be good at everything. You have to have your weaknesses, and it just so happens that war dogs are a ginormous weakness for the pikes. Saying that, they do make great allies, because when the war dogs are in combat, like they are here, I could potentially go in there with my pikes down and not do friendly fire. You do friendly fire to the handlers, but not the war dogs themselves. So that's a bit of a tip. That opens up a lot of cool strats you can pull off with your teammates. Or you can pull your teammate off with. Another thing I'd like to mention about pikes, I don't know how to segue into this shit, so I'm just going to bring it up. Here's a random tip out of nowhere. When you are playing them, near a cliff face, make sure you don't actually click on the cliff. Because what will happen is your pikes will raise. Even when you don't want them to, they will just raise up in the air and wave it around like they just don't care. Anyway guys, that's basically the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe, the thumbs up and all that shit. And I'll see you next time.